Hello everyone. So today I come again with another essay of UPSC 2020 and the topic is ships do not sink because of water around them. Ships sink because water gets into them. It's so logical, isn't it? One would wonder what is so special about it. What is special is that they've taken up for an essay topic. So we have to write 1,000 words first of all. It's a quotation of Bible. You know, when I first read it, I felt, oh, probably he's just a sailor and that's what came naturally to him. But then it is captured and just, you know, one could relate to it and that is why it is here. And we have to think and see what we can, what substance we can add to this essay, right? So ships do not sink because of water. Now, what do you think have they taken up? What are we supposed to do here? Probably this is a personification. Right? So personification is what? Where an inanimate thing or a body or is compared to somebody, some human being or some person. So personification of ship to a human being. So ship, and then they have water. I've written the short form there. Water. That is probably everything else and everybody around you. It could be the environment and the friends included. It could include everything other than you. Got that? So personification of the ship. Ship and what? So this is how we are going to approach the essay. And that is how we will be able to reach 1,000 words. So first of all, we take that we consider it's a personification. And let us consider this, that ship is a body. And water is all the surrounding. And we have to be very sure that we are not affected by anybody else outside. And so that we are safe and we are able to complete the targets and whatever we've decided and whatever we want successfully. Fine. So you take that as a first paragraph. You will tell, you will have conveyed to the examiner that you understood what the gist is. Now, after this, we go into detail. So now, why do you think ship has been taken up? Why is ship taken up? When you think of ship, what do you think? You think of the size, which is large, massive, mammoth, enormous, right? So these are the things which you think and very, very important, very powerful, large, powerful, enormous. So that is what the size of the ship is. And then So from here we consider that, and then also I said we can consider the ship to the body. But when we talk about the ship, there is something else which is very, very important, without which the ship will not go. Your body will not go without it either. So you can call it the soul, but here for our purposes, I will call it the mind. Body plus mind. And in the ship, I would say, in the ship, what do we have? We have the ship plus captain. The captain is very important. The ship is as good as the captain, right? Similarly, the body and the mind. So both are very important. And that is the ship which we will consider here. It is the body and the mind. Yes, if you want to add, you can add plus spirituality, the soul. So these are the things which are important, which we will consider when we talk about the ship. Right? So now, we told in the first paragraph that it is a personification. Later we consider second paragraph, we start with the ship and we start considering with the body and the mind with the captain. So what should we do? Every time there should be comparisons now. So there are two reasons for comparisons again and again, very loud comparisons when you say in your mind. One is that you keep yourself on track. You know that yes, you cannot be diverted. Very soon you come back to the track. You say something and you again talk about the relevance or the comparison, so you're on the track. Secondly, you tell the, again and again, remind the examiner that, main track pe hoon. So both the things are done, right? So, first of all, just like, so again, just like the ships before taking a journey have to be serviced, maintained, overhauled, whichever words you can think of, serviced. So all that thing is there, repaired, painted so that, you know, it's not rusted or anything. All those things are there for the ship. Similarly for the body, what is important is that we have to take care that our physical fitness is there, medical checkups, health, daily regime of exercise, walking, all these things are there for the physical part. And the mental part is very important. As students or as aspirants of IAS, you all are studying very hard. But we are talking about human being in general. So when you start going to work or some other things, these things get neglected. Especially for ladies, for, you know, normally reading and other hobbies get neglected. But then we need fuel for the mind too. So that is very important to have hobbies and so that your mind is also active. So this is what? Working on the mind. Reading something, meeting, attending conferences, webinars. So this is very important. The body and the mind is what we have to look. Then spirituality. So whatever you want to read mythology or you want to have satsang, if you believe in that. Or again, we have the other ways of meditation or yoga or reading about Bhagavad Gita and mythology. So all these things will make you, but spirituality is what? Goodness. It makes you strong there. So these things are there. So all these things are like servicing the ship. Looking at working on all these things is like servicing the ship. If all these things are strong, if you have your, then you will not succumb to sudden cardiac arrest or diabetes going up. So your health are, or just fatigue. Why talk about something else? Just fatigue maybe. So you will be able to cope up. You will be able to take stress. Because stress is part of, it's going to come in life. So at least, now for example, again, let me come to the current scenario of COVID or the pandemic. Those who are strong within could restrain the or fight against the corona. Those who were not succumbed to it. Got that? I think this explains what I'm trying to say is that we have to service ourselves. We have to have our regular checkups. We have to take care. We cannot neglect it in any way. So just if we can do that the same way. Because ships, we know they're going to unknown waters. They're not going to the service stations. On the road, at least you will find, if I'm going, maybe there'll be Maruti Center or some other service center, you'll find you have a flat wheel. But nevertheless, here we are not going to find in the when you go, unless there is another dock, another harbour you go. So we have to make sure that our body is strong and our mind is strong, and we, even our goodness and as our heart and mind is at place, right? So this thing is very important. So this is very important as leaders, as human beings, when you embark on any mission. Everybody has a mission statement. Now yours is passing the eyes. And later it will be whatever job you have, that will be your mission statement for that. So this is very important. Now when you talk about this, also you can talk about how it is important to learn certain things. In this you learn. Because if something goes wrong, you have to take care. So you have to have a first aid box. You might carry some things. Supposing you have a cardiac arrest, what do I do? Similarly in the ship, you have a maintenance engineer with you on board. But here you are yourself. You need to know what, if something, carry your medicines with you, don't you? So this is what. We're not talking only of young children like you who are young and healthy. We're talking about people in general for two reasons. One is you need to think on a broader spectrum. You think of everybody and not about your good health at this age or the prime of your life, 24, 25. You are robust health. Good. God bless. But then generally one has to be prepared. So this is what it is. So, and if that does not happen, then you will succumb. That is very important. That is what we have to be very careful. That should not happen to us. There's another thing. What happens? What happens is that sometimes there are rats. rats and rodents. When I talk about rats and rodents, maybe in an organization there will be spies or somebody gives the inside information. So that cleansing has to happen if you are an organization head. Because why? Because ghar ka bhedi lanka dhai. So no matter how strong the ship is, if somebody has tampered and created a hole in the ship, then the water is bound to come in and the ship will sink. The water will get in. So we have to be very careful about that. The water has to be outside, and anybody you think will tamper the organization or the system, for that matter, that person has not to be allowed to do that. We have to be very careful about that. Got that? So it will again prove the point. Ships sink because water gets into them, and we have to make sure that the water does not get into them. Right? Other than that, we have to, that is one thing. That is the most important thing. You work on yourself and you do that. The other thing is, you have to make sure that you do not take unnecessary risks. The ship is very strong, fine. Till now you have told that. Now you need to extend a little more. You still have words, limit to fill in. So make sure you do not take unnecessary risks. You have to have weather forecast before the ship goes. There has to be a weather forecast that there are no storms indicated. The waters will not be rough. There is no tsunami coming up. We have fishermen are normally stopped when the weathers are rough or the waters get rough. So similarly, in the organizations or anywhere you are, you have to be clear that you are not on the wrong side of law. Don't take unnecessary risks. So if you do that, then you're getting into trouble. So again, so follow the law, all the regulations, whatever is stipulated, that has to be done. If you tamper those things, if you play, for example, there are provisions for fire safety in an organization and some stipulations which you have to follow, or pollution stipulations you have to follow, you do not follow them. What happens? There could be a fire and everybody is caught in that and you are trapped and there will be a tragedy. You may be answerable. So all these things, when they go for shortcuts and making quick profits, and that is when you let slowly the environment affect you and the water gets into them and you come down, lock, stock, barrel, everything finished, and you might end up behind bars as a human being. So this is how you will approach the topic. At least this is one way. This is not the only way. This is one way which I have said. So you can think of more ways like this. More examples will come to you when you read this or listen to this, and you can accordingly elaborate. But here we've talked about basically the body, mind and spirituality. As a leader, I've talked about, and the more important you are in the hierarchy, the more important you are, the more responsible you will have to be to the people. So like the captain of the ship. So ship, the body, mind, the captain, and water is all the environment and people, making sure that you do not go get into unnecessary trouble. Right? So this is what I have for you. Signing off, Kulmat Kaur. If you like the video, please share it. Motivates me, no matter with my grey hair, I still look for motivation. It feels nice. But more than that, I'd be very happy if you can write and practice, and it really helps you. That I feel very happy with. Thank you so much. God bless you.